anthropologist Mariano Otta, and the former editor of the Daily Star, Don Neeson. Ladies, good to see you again. And Don, we're starting with you. It's the front of the Daily Express, your first choice. Ukrainian spies believe that there is potentially
This is Putin's plot to blackmail the world, as you can see there. Russia's elite stockpiling corpses of dead Ukrainian soldiers to plant as evidence of a forced fire operation at Chernobyl. This is what Ukrainian officials are blaming. Key military intelligence are saying that Vladimir Putin plans to release radioactive waste in what would amount to a terrorist attack, basically, and then blame the Ukraine for doing so.
My list is slightly dodgy, but you've got a story in the FT, I just can't work out which one it is, G7 on jets.
Well, we talked about the G7, so the G7 have agreed to break off trade ties with Russia, so Russia will be able to, in the past three weeks, have been able to complete business as usual, but this really cements it. And it goes hand in hand with the announcement from the EU leaders as well, with this Versailles declaration saying that they're going to rearm and also work to become sovereign, so independent as a bloc for food security and military. And so one of the other things that this conflict has really clearly clear in our minds is how interconnected, how interdependent we are, and how much as we'd love to turn off the taps and stop the ships bringing Russian liquid petroleum, gas and oil, and those pipelines that crisscross the European sort of landmass. It's incredibly hard to, and you can't do it overnight, and it means that we're still paying Russia money, even though we condemn what they're doing. So, of course, there are the levers or the trade sanctions being implemented, and they will have a punishing impact on Russian people, of course. The big question is, how much does Putin care about how much his own people are suffering, or will he say, you take it on the chin because I'm pursuing this imperialistic strategy to expand Great Mother Russia? And I think the other thing we shouldn't forget is that there is pro-Putin support. There are many people who are protesting the war in Russia, but there are pro-Putin rallies that are being held in Belarus, in Serbia. It's not as simple as
David Goliath and everybody is condemning Russia. Of course, China on the main ferry side, like on this recently. Yeah, Don, one thing that I think will almost necessarily follow is the story in front of the Telegraph that the will be used to defend spending, whether or not it will quite as far as Jeremy Hunt from a foreign secretary is calling to increase to the same level as the US. I'm presuming that's in percentage of GDP rather than in real terms.
Yes, it is. Obviously, and one of the UK Waste Management 2.3% of our GDP, which is the gross domestic product, on defence, whilst America's Men 3.5%. And this is an explicit decision to have half with the Jeremy Hunt, if I'm down, before the foreign secretary. They're saying that we now, given this situation, which lets me honest, we could have seen coming, couldn't we? I mean, it's not something. Oh my God, very good news, isn't it? Here's now suggesting that we do need to concentrate on defence spending more. I mean, the interesting thing is, if you look back at the figures of spending in this country now, I mean, sort of like health spending is now 142 billion pounds, and that has been increasing literally from 1990 up until now every single year. Meanwhile, defence has actually gone down every single year. We are now spending £41.2 billion on defence, which sounds an awful lot, but in the great scheme of things, it absolutely isn't. And it's like, you know, Trump was very, very vocal when he was president about NATO's defence spending and very critical of it. And Jeremy Hunt was actually saying that, you know, okay, he might have put it, Trump might have put it in a very obvious way, but he had a point. And really, we do need now in this country, given how unstable Europe is, to actually maybe consider spending more on defence. So it was very interesting when the Ukrainian president was addressing the House of Commons that standing ovation, everyone applauding, you know, we're going to do our bit to help you. Some of the hypocrisy going on there, given the vast majority of our people actually voted against increasing defence spending.
I'm so sorry, I'm going to have to leave it there. Marianne, do bring back your story for the next hour of Russia accusing the US of plotting to use birds to suspend pathogens. Marianne, Don, we'll see you shortly. But after the break, we of course have the very latest as the Russian forces continue at slow advance on Kiev.